Hi, I'm Michelle, and an Idahoan that has a love for the great outdoor opportunities that exist in our state. Recently, I've learned that something different is happening here in the Payette National Forest. For the past 5 years, the forest has been a part of the Collaborative Forest Landscape Restoration Program, and forest restoration work is in full swing within these ecosystems. An important part of this program is the collaborative process that the Payette Forest Coalition is a key player in. The Payette Forest Coalition is an independent group of interested members of the public that represent all interest in land stewardship. For these projects, the Payette National Forest and Payette Forest Coalition came together to increase the scale and pace of forest restoration projects, improve communication and trust, and understand values and needs of various interest groups. And accomplishments are taking place. So what's different? What were the issues of the past that led to the status quo of little work being done in the woods? And how have those troubles been removed through a truly collaborative effort?
No one is particularly happy with the status quo. If you're in the conservation interest, there isn't a lot of forest restoration going on there. From the forest products industry, there isn't a lot of commercial activity going on. From recreationists, there isn't a lot of trail maintenance going on, and there's lots of concerns out there.
The management was stagnant, and there was nothing going on.
The perception by forest leaders, the coalition, and the public was critical work needed to increase, but landscape scale level projects were slow, and projects were stalled or stopped due to a lengthy planning process, appeals, and litigations.
By getting a forum together to work out these issues in advance and find a zone of agreement, the Forest Service can start off a project on the right foot and then end up in a spot where they can actually get work done on the ground that everyone supports.
In 2009, Congress passed legislation that authorized the Collaborative Forest Landscape Restoration Program, known as the CFLRP. That act provided authority for the Forest Service to engage collaboratives for landscape scale projects. In 2012, the Weezer Little Salmon Headwaters Restoration Project here on the Payette National Forest was selected to receive annual funding for 8 years. Through that authority, the Payette Forest Coalition developed recommendations and brought the interest of all parties together for several projects. These collaboratively developed projects significantly increased the scale and pace of forest landscape restoration.
We convened, and by we, I mean a broad spectrum of people representing a variety of different interests, from loggers and motorized recreationists to non-motorized recreationists, county government, business people. And we all got together and talked about what we would like to see happen on the Payette National Forest. And the one thing we agreed upon pretty quickly was that we would like to see work get done on the forest.
These projects that bring the interest of all parties to the table have promoted economic growth and improved forest and watershed health. They have enhanced fish and wildlife habitat through vegetation thinning, road improvements, riparian enhancements, invasive species management, and fuels treatment. Today, the Payette National Forest is actively managing 130,000 acres within the Mill Creek, Council Mountain, and Lost Creek, Boulder Creek watersheds north of Council, Idaho. In addition, they are working on 50,000 more acres in the Weezer River watershed.
We need large-scale solutions to some big problems we have. And landscape's getting away from those smaller analysis areas, going bigger, and really trying to treat these vast areas we have around here with some pretty darn big projects.
The goal of the Forest Service is to redevelop ecologically sound systems and watersheds that function naturally and have openings and vegetation patterns that are somewhat similar to the past, when fire played a dominant role. Each project is helping to improve watershed health by reducing road sediment, add or replace road culverts with open bottom arches to allow easy fish passage, and reduce dense vegetation that pose fire risks. Much of the Payette National Forest is within a fire-adapted ecosystem, meaning historically, frequent lower intensity fires reduce fuel that created natural diversity, such as forest openings, meadows, and desirable animal habitat.
What we found is there's a lot of work to do because you have areas of the forest stands that have missed a lot of fire cycles. We had a lot of brush and trees that have grown up that normally wouldn't be there.
The coalition advocates prescribed fire combined with timber projects at a landscape level. That management approach changes forest vegetation conditions so they are more resilient to wildfire while providing economic and social benefits. After mechanical vegetation removal, adding fire under a controlled environment mimics the historic fire rule. Each year, forest personnel use prescribed fire on thousands of acres following vegetation reduction from timber sales.
We go out and look at an area that we visited prior to treatment, and we saw how dense and overgrown it was. And then we go back out after veg treatment and look at it again and say, oh, now we understand how the firefighters would be able to get in here and fight a fire successfully and not have it blow up and consume 100,000 acres.
If we can take some areas and through our restoration work, reduce the severity of those catastrophic fires, I think that's a positive all the way around.
As a part of their collaborative goals, projects have been developed that generate increased timber value and much needed good restoration work.
Through these projects, we're able to generate a lot of value in the timber. I've always said that timber is just an outcome of good restoration work.
The Evergreen Sawmill near New Meadows has added a second shift due largely to the Lost Creek, Boulder Creek project, and frequently posts a help wanted sign. These projects have also helped fill log yards from Meridian to Grangeville.
Lost Creek, Boulder Creek, that's roughly 65, 70 million board feet. So now we have timber target met for roughly 3 years. That's a far cry from where we were 10 years ago.
It's allowed us to increase shifts. It's given me the more of the confidence that we can hire more people on, that we can grow the company. And I hope they keep just doing these projects, because every time you see these projects, it's a win-win for everybody.
The win-win comes by thinning the overgrown forest and by providing economic stability to these mountain towns. The effort also focuses on road management and recreational opportunities, and those two can present a challenging debate. But bringing people together to talk about these issues produces an outcome that reaps strong benefits.
When it comes to these roads, we have a variety of people using the forest in a variety of ways. And some folks would like to see lots more ATV trails. Other folks would like to see ATVs banned from the woods. So how do we come to an agreement somewhere in between?
The Forest Service developed projects that reduced road impacts, but maintain public access, emergency access regarding wildfire, and for future land stewardship projects.
In a lot of places, there's roads are redundant. So they'll get a road out of the stream bottom and leave a road on a ridge top or a mid-slope, still keep access.
We were actually able to recommend more miles of road decommissioning and more miles of stream restored than the Idaho Conservation League would have done on its own. At the same time, we were able to work with recreationists, and they were actually able to designate some recreational loops that otherwise wouldn't have been available. So coming together, we actually found a sweet spot for both recreation interests as well as wildlife and fisheries and sporting interests.
The Lost Creek Watershed and Lost Valley Reservoir are very popular recreational areas. Recreation improvements were needed, and the collaborative effort brought people together to make improvements.
It was very important to include in that project some work to improve those dispersed campsites, to move a few sites away from the immediate shore of the reservoir, to harden some sites so there'd be less erosion, less resource damage, to put in some vault toilets so we don't have sanitation concerns up there like we had before. It was not a pleasant place to be. And now it is going to be a much more pleasant place for people to go and camp and take their families and their kids and go fishing.
The bottom line is that collaboration works. Already these accomplishments include 84,000 acres of fuel treatment, 132 miles of stream restoration, 90,000 acres of wildlife habitat enhancement, 16 stream crossings improved for aquatic organism passage, nearly 150,000 CCF of timber sold, enhanced and upgraded recreational opportunities, and 10,000 acres of noxious weed treatment. The status quo has changed. Forest restoration is taking place, such as this vegetation treatment and the use of prescribed fire. The collaborative process has also helped to effectively deal with the litigation issues. When the Lost Creek Boulder Creek project was challenged in court by non-collaborative parties, the Payette Forest Coalition intervened on behalf of the Forest Service. The federal court cited the strong collaborative and community support and dismissed the lawsuit.
It's exciting to see a federal judge say, no, this is a good project. A lot of people from different interests came together to collaborate and agree on a project. Through this process, we're getting some progress done and we're keeping people working. We're adding some new jobs.
The benefit is an increased pace and scale of landscape restoration. Project planning is now more efficient, and on-the-ground results are healthy, resilient, sustainable landscapes.
What the collaborative does is it creates a forum for folks who are usually on opposite sides of many of these issues to come together and try to work some things out in advance.
It's just a good way to do business face-to-face.
Everything that you're doing right
exactly.
now, guys.
The more we talk, the more we realize we have a lot in common and what we want to see. We share a lot of the same values.
It's been very gratifying to see work get done on the ground in real time so that our forests are healthier, they're more resilient to wildfire. In addition, we're having healthier wildlife habitat and fishing places, and also better recreational opportunities for everyone. So it's a lot of work, but it is working.
All of us value our public lands and want to see these incredible forested ecosystems survive for generations to come. Forest restoration has started in these special places like the Payette National Forest, and the collaborative process is key to implementing positive results in the landscape. Collaboration brings our values together, and together more and more forested lands are being proactively brought back into healthy conditions. If you're an interested Idahoan like me, learn more about the collaborative process and then pull up a chair to the table so that these significant accomplishments through collaboration can continue into the future.